Well, we got our cross member installed using a hydraulic jack to press it back into the car, and the bolts are in loosely now. And the mount bolts are in loosely, and the transmission's all the way down right now just to make it easier to put things back together. When we're done, it'll be up another half to three quarters of an inch. I guess about a half inch. You can see our little fin here we added to the front. This is the original one out of the car, and we bought another one to cut up, basically in case we messed up the first time. We had to substantially modify this cross member, and as you can see, this is a lot thicker than your average transmission cross member, because it's not just swung up the transmission, it's a structural part of the perimeter frame system. It actually presses into the receptacles on the frame where it's bolted in. So it's a tight fit, and it appears to be designed for torsional rigidity, keep the frame straight. So we wanted to maintain as much of that integrity as we could while allowing clearance for the 10R80 or the 6R80. And actually, what works for 10R80 works for 6R80 because they pretty much have the same mount dimensions between the two transmissions, or at least within an eighth of an inch. So that's good news. It makes things a lot easier. So we know this would be useful with the 6R80 as well. So we basically needed to cut out this section because the mount comes off horizontally off the back with three bosses at the back of the transmission. And as we mentioned before, we used the Stifler's mount bracket with the energy suspension urethane bushing in it, which is a really nice piece. And it's a lot shorter than the factory mount, which would have gone below the bottom of the cross member. So that wasn't practical. That was the best fit for the cross member and allowed the least amount of surgery. So we opted for that. We pretty much had to cut the whole top section out of the cross member. And back here, we cut all the way back to the back wall and even cut in a little bit here to ensure that we had clearance for the companion flange on the back of the transmission and the drive shaft flange, because they're right there. So we wanted to maximize our clearance to make sure we never hit. We don't want that. Started out by basically removing a huge chunk. The whole mount pad from the 4R70W had to go because it would hit the pan on the 6R or the 10R80. So we cut that off and then cut in at about a 45 degree angle on each side all the way to the back wall. Made those cuts. And then we cut off the front part that I showed you a minute ago. We cut into the weld seam by about a half inch up to about here. And we will publish some templates on this to show more or less what we did dimensionally. And we flattened that weld seam up, and then we filled the weld seam as best we could. And we also inserted an eighth inch thick piece of steel on each side. In this area, there was a gap there, and they're just welded here and here. We filled that up so we'd have extra rigidity there to close up those gaps. And so once we did that, we basically had a shelf here, and this is the hole we drilled for the transmission mount where the single half inch bolt goes through, and we'll use spacer washers to adjust up and down as needed. Once we got everything cut off, we cut two pieces. We actually used a piece of 3/16 inch thick by 3 inch wide steel for everything. I apologize for the ugly welding. I don't have the best welding equipment or skill, so this is actually a prototype, so I wouldn't sell this to anybody else. But we cut pieces to fit in here, and we've got templates of that to close off and terminate the torsional motion at this wall here with the bottom and the top in the back. We did that on both sides. Then we cut a piece here to fill up the back, and we drilled some holes in it and welded through the holes just to connect it better on the three sides, and then on the top we welded it too. And finally, you know, we still, our twisting motion would come through the bottom and the back, which is double thickness now. But we still felt that wasn't rigid enough. So we did some experiments and decided that a 3/16 inch plate on the front would be very useful to restore the rigidity, or as much as possible, the original cross member. It's thicker material too than the original metal. So this plate basically is welded to the weld seam all along and then welded to the bottom piece on the top and bottom, and then in here and here. And we made this as large as possible. It was a 3-inch thick piece, and we cut a V-shaped notch in there to clear the bosses on the transmission, the mounting bosses. And we made it as low as we could without causing ground clearance problems. And hopefully that'll be all right. We'll have a nut sticking down here too, so hopefully we won't have to shorten that anymore later, but we wanted the maximum rigidity we can get. So we felt this was a good compromise and preserved the integrity of the cross member while giving us the clearance we need. And then when we get it in the car, we'll adjust the height, as I mentioned, spacer washers, and get the drive shaft angle where it should be. We're basically going for the same angle at the rear flange that we had with the 4R70W, which will preserve all the drive shaft angles going back.